Not in North Carolina.
Okay.
What?
He's never even been to Charlotte. He's already shutting it down. You can't shut down anything you've never tried.
I'm not even.
So, we've been together for almost 3 years. How do you feel about our relationship?
I think our relationship is really strong. We get along very well. We have a lot of fun together. It's like really hanging out with one of the homies. Like we just have a good time all the time. Like we have fun.
All the time.
We try to have fun. Everybody has that one friend where you can just like go to the house and kick you with. Like just kick it. And you just have fun no matter what it is you guys decide to get into. I think that's how we are.
I agree. I have a lot of guy friends, but he's like my guy friend that I can kick it with and love on. And touch his muscles.
This, as far as making videos, what is your number one goal?
My main goal in making these videos is really just to reach an audience and spread positive vibes. There's so much negative stuff that we see on a daily basis, on TV, social media, so I just want to be a positive light in someone's life and try to be, you know, motivation for someone to follow their dreams and to love themselves and to get healthy. That's my only motivation, is just to help people.
So you're trying to be a black doctor for you, but like a female black doctor?
I guess, but mainly just a black Ashley Ray. That's it. Just a black me.
Just a black Ashley.
Just a black me. That's it.
Just say me.
Just me. I'm already black, but I'm just trying to be a blacker me, I guess. Because you know I like to get tan and everything in the summertime, so I'm going to be darker in a couple months anyway.
Next question.
Yeah, what's your favorite thing about me?
Well, one thing I like about you is, that's a little peeny mother. One thing I like about you is that, for one, we're totally different. I'm more of an introvert. She's an extrovert. So that's where we kind of clash. But that's what I like about her.
I'm loud.
So it has to be probably one of the things that's attracts me the most to her, is that she's not what I am, you know. So yeah, I like that you're out, you know, and you're goofy like that.
Yeah, you are goofy. He's a closet goof. Okay, so where do you see us in the next 5 years?
Dallas or Arizona, not North Carolina.
Okay.
What?
He's never even been to Charlotte. He's already shutting it down. You can't shut down anything you've never tried.
I'm not even shutting down North Carolina, you know.
I'm gonna get him hooked one day.
I'm not shutting down North Carolina.
I already got him hooked once, so I can get him hooked again.
Dallas or Arizona, I think, is where we'll be in 5 years. We would like to be in California, chilling, hanging with Zuri and Menton. What up, y'all? But, you know.
Okay, Zuri and Menton, I love you guys to death.
We gonna be out there. We will be there.
But unless y'all are helping us pay for the cost of living, we'll just be staying with you. Keep our room ready.
If there was one thing that you wanted people to remember you by, what would it be?
Fearless. I would say fearless. And I'm not there yet, so I'm working towards being a fearless person, but I think I'm just into my 30s, that this is the decade for me to be...
You're 30.
I know I look 22, y'all. Don't tell me. I think this is the decade for me to be completely fearless and go towards my dreams without being scared. It's a little scary to go after all these crazy thoughts that I have in my head. But I'm really getting to the point where I'm just kind of like, screw it, I'ma go for it, and if I fail, which I will in some instances, and so I already have.
So you're a hard charger then, right?
I'm a hard charger. Y'all hold me to that.
Yeah, I'm a hold to that.
Okay. So what do you think is the key to keeping our relationship really strong?
It may sound a little cliche, but I would say communication. I mean, that's one thing that I think we had from the get-go, like from right out of the gate. Like we always communicate with each other. We always tell each other about our feelings. And a lot of guys out there, like, you need to listen up. Like, you always feel like, yo, I'm hard. You you know, she ain't gonna know, I ain't gonna tell her my feelings, I'm gonna play, you know, this role, I'm gonna be this, I'm gonna be that. Throw all that out the window, you know, like you have to tell her how you feel. So guys are always saying, you know, I can't read your mind, just tell me what you want to eat today. What do you want to eat? You know,
I don't know. I mean, it doesn't really matter what I eat.
Same thing goes for us.
Whatever you want to eat.
Yeah, same things go for us. We have to tell them how we feel. You know, we can't just try to be all hard and, you know, gang bang on breakfast and that's
it. Let me get some bacon, son. What you want to eat? Can I get some eggs, bacon, butter biscuits, butter baked biscuits?
That was an inside joke. If you watch Cat Williams, you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, and I just added my own mix-up in there.
Yeah, I had nothing to do with it.
But we do communicate really well. I do think that's one of the parts of our relationship. Obviously, we have arguments from time to time, but they're very small, insignificant arguments, and that's because typically if we have an issue about something, we literally just sit down and talk it out. And we don't shut down each other's feelings, we just listen to each other. And so that's something that I feel that really makes our relationship strong too. Because there's things that I'll have on my heart or in my mind, and if I want to talk to him about it, I don't feel afraid that he'll just shut it down right then. He always is like very calm and listens to what I have to say and how I feel, even if he doesn't agree with it.
Don't dismiss feelings, you know, it's because that's how they feel. Even though it's not how you feel, it's how they feel. So you gotta take that into account. So let's say it's 2026, where are you?
So married with two kids, in great shape, and hopefully I've reached the world in trying to help people live a healthier, better life.
Do you still hope you're talking to all these fine people in 10 years?
I hope I'm still talking to you all in 10 years. I don't foresee myself in Indiana. I foresee myself in some warmer weather. But I really just want to see us grow together and doing what we love, which is spreading, you know.
Now, you know, 10 years, that's longer than what the Freddie Prinze show was running. It only ran for 7 years.
I know, but who knows where this all takes us. Okay, so name one thing that gets on your nerves about me. Besides nothing.
She gets on my nerves sometimes. You do. You do. But I know it's out of love, you know, so she only helps me push, you know, she pushes me to where I need to be, where she knows what I'm capable of doing. And I really appreciate that. And that's love in itself, because some women and men can love you, but they will let you be comfortable in your space where you're not growing or anything like that, right?
Right.
So they're not really helping you build. Like, she actually helps me build, and vice versa. I feel like I help her build in certain areas. So yeah, you know, thank you for that.
You're welcome, son.
You know, you always got my back, and I always got yours. So you know, like, everybody has their flaws or whatnot. By the way, I think flaws are what makes you unique, you know? So it's like when you like somebody, you like them and their flaws.
Yeah.
You know? So, like, really, it's like some of your flaws, I don't think it's all that bad.
See, guys, I am easy to get along with.
What's something you don't like about me?
Something I don't like about you.
Oh my God, Tora, this.
Actually, no, because I'm the outgoing one, and I'm the one who's like, always turned up, and so he calms things down for me, because I can stay turned from like 5A to 10P. So he helps me to pump my brakes, and he's always very chill about stuff, and that definitely helps me, because I'll be on 100 real quick for a long time.
I'm sure a lot of people like to be interactive with you.
Yeah.
So when can they expect them to be interactive with you?
Well, you can always drop comments at the bottom if you want to be interactive. If you want to see something different, you can also drop some more comments. But I do have a lot of ideas for the channel, so I hope to kind of make this different and make it fun and make it real. And, you know, hopefully you guys can learn from me and him and whoever else I have on the channel. So thank you, babe, for joining me on Ashley's Way.
You're welcome.
Will you be back?
I might be back. I'm pretty sure I'll be back.
No, he'll be back.
I might be back. So where's the subscribe button? Right here.
It's down below.
Right here.
Somewhere in this.
No, it's right here.
Okay.
So hit this button right here and then a like button. Where is that? Is that like right here?
Yeah, something like that.
So subscribe and like.
Hit both of those buttons for me, please. And also, if you would share this video, I would very much appreciate it. If you have any comments, put them down below. And if there's things that you would like to see, put them down below. All right, thank you so much for coming to Ashley's Way. Thank you for joining me and my beautiful man, Jason. And I'll be back. Bye.
Peace out. Have a good one.